The midday worship and the offering of food in the temples were over. The bells, gongs, and cymbals of the arati were being played, and the temple garden was filled with joyful activity. Beggars, sadhus, and guests hurried to the guest house for the noonday meal, carrying leaf or metal plates in their hands. M also took some of the prasad from the Kali temple. Sri Ramakrishna had been resting a while after his meal when several devotees, including Ram and Girindro, arrived. They sat down after saluting the master. The conversation turned to the new dispensation church of Keshab Chandra Sen. Ram to the master. Sir, I don't think the Navavidhan has done people any good. If Keshab Babu himself was a genuine man, why are his disciples left in such a plight? I don't think there is anything at all in the new dispensation. It is like rattling some potsherds in a room and then locking it up. People may take it to be the jingling of coins, but inside there is nothing but potsherds. Outsiders don't know what is inside. Master, there must be some substance in it. Otherwise, why should so many people respect Keshab? Why isn't Shivanath honored as much as Keshab? Such a thing cannot happen without the will of God. But a man cannot act as an acharya without renouncing the world. People won't respect him. They will say, "Oh, he is a worldly man. He secretly enjoys woman and gold himself, but tells us that God alone is real and the world unsubstantial, like a dream." Unless a man renounces everything, his teachings cannot be accepted by all. Some worldly people may follow him. Keshab led the life of a householder. Hence his mind was directed to the world also. He had to safeguard his family interests. That is why he left his affairs in such good order, though he delivered so many religious lectures. What an aristocratic man he married his daughter to! Inside Keshab's inner apartments, I saw many big bedsteads. All these things gradually come to one who leads a householder's life. The world is indeed a place for enjoyment. Ram, Keshab Sen inherited those bedsteads when his ancestral property was divided. And for Keshab to take part in the division of property. Whatever you may say, sir, Vijay Babu told me that Keshab had said to him, "I am a partial manifestation of Christ and Gauranga. I suggest you declare yourself as Advaita." Footnote: Advaita, an intimate companion of Gauranga. Footnote ends. Do you know what else he said? He said that you too were a follower of the new dispensation. all laugh. Master, laughing. Who knows? But as for myself, I don't even know what the term new dispensation means. Laughter. Ram. Keshav's disciples say that he was the first to harmonize Jnana and Bhakti. Master. In surprise. How is that? What then of the Adhyatma Ramayana? It is written there that while praying to Rama, Narada said, O Ram, thou art the supreme Brahman described in the Vedas. Thou dwellest with us as man. Thou appearest as a man. In reality, thou art not a man. Thou art that supreme Brahman. Rama said, Narad, I am very much pleased with you. Accept a boon from me. Narada replied, What boon shall I ask of thee? Grant me pure love for thy lotus feet, and may I never be deluded by thy world-bewitching Maya. The Adhyatma Ramayana is full of such statements regarding Jnana and Bhakti.